कंपाउंड एपिथीलियम, लास्ट टाइम वी स्टडीड अबाउट ए सिंपल एपिथीलियम दैट इज मेड अप ऑफ ओनली वन लेयर ऑफ दिस सेल्स. ऑन द अदर हैंड द कंपाउंड एपिथीलियम, दिस एपिथीलियम इज मल्टी लेयर्ड. एपिथीलियम इज मल्टी लेयर्ड. मल्टीलेयर एंड फाउंड इन द फाउंड in the region of body with rapid wear and tear. Wear and tear means that the where rapid means where rapid rapid replacement is needed, where rapid replacement is needed in the that region. And they are mainly protective in function. They are mainly protective in function and they are found in the region having wear and the tear. Only in this case, since it is the multilayer, so only lower layer of cells is held on basement membrane. Basement only lower layer of the cells is held on basement membrane. Now this is also divided into two categories, or we can say that the compound epithelium is of two types. So compound epithelium is of two types. Compound epithelium is of two types. Number one is stratified. Number one is stratified. Compound epithelium. Number one is stratified compound epithelium, and number two is transitional. Second is transitional transitional compound epithelium have stratified and the transitional compound epithelium. So this is the stratified epithelium. It is part of several layers of cells. It is formed of several layers of cells. Usually, it is part of several layers of the cells, that is usually 5 to 8 layers. 5 to 8 layers of the cells. While on the other hand, transitional epithelium is formed of, it is formed of only a few layers of cells. Usually 4 to 5 layers of cells. What happens is that one is the it is form of several layers of cells, it is form of only few layers of the cells, and that is usually 4 to 5 layers of the cells, while this is 5 to 8 layers of the cells. So, and it is found only a few places of the body, as it is in the ureters, found in the ureters, urinary bladder, and when region that is the renal pelvis, and these are location of the transitional compound epithelium. So this is the stratified compound epithelium. It is part of several layers of the cells. So that is a stratified epithelium is of 4 types. Stratified compound epithelium is of 4 types. These 4 types: A is the stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. One is stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. First one, the stratified keratinized and squamous epithelium. Next one is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. Second one is the certified cuboidal epithelium and says stratified columnar epithelium. Columnar epithelium and D is the ciliated stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. So we have to discuss one by one. First we discuss about the stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. Actually this stratified squamous epithelium, it is of two types. One the keratinized and other non-keratinized. One is keratinized and other is non-keratinized. Let us discuss about. So first we have to discuss in detail about the stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. So first we are going to study about the stratified compound epithelium. This is the stratified compound epithelium, and in this stratified, for some time we write only the stratified epithelium in under the heading the compound epithelium. So stratified compound epithelium, and in which A we are studying A, that one is the stratified stratified keratinized and sometimes cornified also asking cornified and squamous epithelium stratified keratinized and are the qualified squamous epithelium. So we have to study in detail about the stratified keratinized epithelium. You are familiar with the horn, to the hoof. These are the structures of the animals, and also about the nails, hairs. These are a few examples of the keratinized squamous epithelium. So we have to study in detail. These are the few examples. So we are studying it first. So study about the cells, only the nature of the different layers of the cell is different. So one layer of the cell, lowermost layer of the cell, which is found or which is held on the basement membrane, So this is a single, this is a layer of the cell. This is the layer of the cell which is held on the basement membrane. And more cells are there. These cells make different layers, as these are the multi-layered. So many cells are there which makes the different layers, and when we move outside, gradually the cell size reduces, as these are the compressed more small size cells are there. These are the cells. So here lowermost layer of the cell is held on the basement membrane. This is the only, as I told you, that is the only lowermost layer of the cell. Lowermost layers of the cells are held on the basement membrane. So this is the basement membrane. Basement basement membrane, and this uppermost layer, stratum corneum. Stratum corneum, and in between the stratum corneum and basement membrane, and now one lowermost layer of the cell is called the stratum RPG. Stratum RPG, and the cells between the stratum RPG and the stratum corneum makes the transitional zone. So this is the structure of the stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. The cells of stratum RPG undergoes into mitosis cell division to produce these cells. These cells push these cells upper sides. As this cell will produce another cell, so these cells produce push the cells which are found in the upper side, and the outermost layer cells of the outermost layers are dead, as their protoplast is replaced by a skeletoprotein called the keratin. So here you can see here the cells the cells produced by mitotic बायमाइटोटिक सेल डिवीजन ऑफ स्टेटम पीकी सेल्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय माइटोटिक सेल डिवीजन ऑफ स्टेटम मालपीगी अंडरगोज two processes, flattening and keratinization. One process is there, keratinization and flattening. So this is very important process of the keratinization. So what happens in the keratinization? The living protoplast of cells gradually replaced by a waterproofing scleroprotein. Waterproofing scleroprotein. Called keratin. So keratin is a scleroprotein, and in these cells the protoplast is gradually replaced by a waterproofing scleroprotein called the keratin. So name given as the stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. Examples, you can write some examples as hoof, nails, you can write hoof, nails, hair, horn. These are derived from it. Horn and draw, etc., are derived from it. You are familiar to the cow and the buffalo. You have also seen the horn. They have the horns. The uppermost layer of horn, that is stratum corneum. This may be replaced if this region is rubbed. There is no pain of that animal. Your the nails are the cut down. There is no pain because these are the dead cells. These are the dead, and they having a protein called the scleroprotein. Or the hairs and the animal's hoof. You have seen. These are the stratified keratinized epithelium. And next one is, there are some, as I told you, that is the stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium are there. And the non-keratinized, next, as I discussed you, non stratified. Stratified and non-keratinized. Non-stratified, non-keratinized squamous epithelium. Epithelium makes lining up. So this is the stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium makes the lining of female urethra, lining of female urethra, ducts of Sweet, ducts of Sweet. So ducts are there, who is producing the Sweets? Larger pancreatic and larger slavery and so stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium makes lining of makes the lining of cornea of eyes of ductal cavity tongue lower part of pharynx etc. I'll connect lower part of the pharynx, oesophagus, and vagina. So these are the reasons where stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium are located. So this is the non-keratinized squamous epithelium, and this is the keratinized. Both are the stratified squamous epithelium, but one squamous epithelium is keratinized and other stratified squamous epithelium is non-keratinized. So stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium makes the lining of cornea of eyes, buccal cavity, tongue, lower part of the pharynx, oesophagus, and the vagina. Now we have to study another type of the tissue after this stratified keratinized. Now next one is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. Next one is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. Next one is D. Stratified. This is stoma. This is cuboidal. Cuboidal epithelium. Stratified cuboidal epithelium. This is stratified cuboidal epithelium. These lines, the female urethra, and ducts of fluid and large slavery and pancreatic ducts these are locations of the stratified cuboid. As name indicate, these make the different strata, but tissues are the cuboidal epithelium. Now next C. C is stratified columnar. Stratified columnar epithelium. Columnar epithelium. These make the lines the male urethra. Lines the male urethra, and last one is D. That one is the stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. These lines, the larynx, and soft palate Subpalate is there, that is the roof of the buccal cavity. It's called palate. The posterior part of the palate is called the subpalate. Thank you, that's my problem.